So, good afternoon, everyone. It was really a good session from the beginning. We are learning from basic, and I'll be just showing some of the chromatograms which are run on DTEN platform in my lab. Mostly, some I have taken from Dr. Soman Tati also. I'll just give you the examples, and I want you all to answer me rather than me telling you all this. It was really nice. So all the chromatograms presented here are of the D10 hemoglobin testing system. I am specifically telling you this because if you run it in a different platform, you will get the area and the peaks all different. So you have to mention it. So this is case one, 44 years male with no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 14.8 gram per dl. RBC is 4.74, hematocrit is 42.4%, MCV 89.5, MCH 31.2, and RDW 12.9%. Here F is less than 0.8, A2 is 32.0, with an unknown peak where the retention time is 3.85. And the area percent is 51.9. The total area is within the limits. So, any guess? What is the chromatogram suggestive of? A2 is raised, F is normal, unknown peak is there with an area of 51.9. Anyone? Dr. Sen sir has so nicely elaborated hemoglobin D with a retention time of 3.8 plus minus 1, and which has, it will not show as a D window. It will not show as a S window because D window always comes after A2 with an unknown peak where the retention time is 3.8 plus minus 1. So it can be from 3.7 to 3.9. Here the retention time is 3.85. So it very nicely falls under hemoglobin D where the percentage is 51.9. Now here A2 is also raised. It's 32. F is normal. So the chromatogram is suggestive of compound heterozygous for hemoglobin D and E. Is it okay? Good. Because you have to see if there is always an unknown peak after A2 with a retention time of 3.7 to 3.9, then it is mostly D. It is D. Yeah, but I have got it in my lab. Very, very rare, very rare. So this was the explanation. Separate peak, unknown window, 3.8 plus minus 0.1. Percentage of D is greater than E. That also has to be remembered. F is normal and the chromatogram is suggestive of compound heterozygous for hemoglobin D and E. This is the next case. 44 years male with no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 12.4. RBC is 4.7. MCV 80.2. MCH 26.4. MCHC is 32.9. RDW is 14.3. Here F is 1.4. A0 is 53.8. A2 is 3.3. And there is a clear-cut S window with a retention time of 4.1 where the area of percentage is 31.7 with normal area count. So what is the diagnosis? It is very simple. Anyone? Anyone? Very, very, very easy this one. S window is there with 31.7. Rest everything is normal. So it is sickle cell trait. Yes, very good. So the hemoglobin S ranges between 30 to 40%. In this case, it is 31.7%, so it is falling. Then the hemoglobin is in of the normal range. RBCs are normocytic, normochromic, and the chromatogram is suggestive of sickle cell trait. Another case, it's a 11 months baby, male, no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 6.6, RBC is 4.87, MCV is 50.7, MCH is 13.6, MCHC is 29.1, RDW is 25.5. Here F is 6.7. There is no unknown peak before F. A1A is 4.9, labile is 1.4, P3 is okay, 6.9. A0 is 57.8, fine. A2 is 18.2. The retention time of A2 is 3.24, with the total area being normal. What is the diagnosis of this chromatogram? E trait with raised F. Just see the, see everything. F is raised, I agree. Then? 11 months. Very good, Dr. Abhishek, thank you. That is the crux of this. 11 months male, it could be. Okay, we have to go for the DNA study to confirm this. See here, hemoglobin lepor also eludes with A2. But in lepor, what happens? A2 is 10 to 18%. Here it is 18.2. Then there is an elevation of F from 3 to 7%. In here it is 6.7%. So it is very well falling. But considering this age of the patient, it could be E trait with coexisting iron deficiency also. So we have to repeat after correction of anemia. That is one. Or it could be hemoglobin lepor 2, which also eludes with A2. But in this case, it could be corrected. The chromatogram can be repeated after correction of anemia. Yeah. I wanted to explain what could be the provisional diagnosis, but I have not reported this. I have got it in my case. I just reported because it is 11 months, it should be repeated. Yeah. But just to share my experience, this I have got recently in my lab. Till now, no. Where do you find the case?
I wanted to say one thing, that whenever you are going to diagnose a hemoglobinopathy, first and foremost thing you should have is to be medically legally safe. Because you may have time to your future endeavor and go for the diagnosis later on. But anything goes over enthusiastic, any stamp we do for a patient, we do it for lifetime. So it's always be safe first, enthusiastic later, in this case of diagnosis at least.
Yeah.
It's
very
a
true.
Fantastic slide, but the slide is so dicey that it can put you to any sort of problem anytime. If the patient, if the baby behaves a bit different, if hemoglobin patterns are still moving, it's still in a fluidic manner, na? So HbF goes down, if HbF goes down, if the same thing, the same pattern, if comes down to less than 18% or goes down to above 20%, the entire diagnosis changes.
Changes,
yeah. So, after 6 months, if the HbF percentage goes down, if it is taken over by A0 or A2, you never know this 18% will turn to 22.
22%.
If it turns to 22, it's a clear case of E-tray.
Yeah.
Isn't it? So it's always been
very dicey. Very dicey, yeah. So we should be always on the safe side to report it safely. But it was really interesting case.
So where you got all these so interesting cases?
This one, I got it in my lab.
Okay. And the ED also?
ED, no.
Oh, ED, they have got.
This is another case. This is 1 year male, no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 6.1. RBC is 4.36. MCV is 48.4. MCH is 14.6. MCHC is 28.9. Here, there is an unknown peak of 0.5%, it should not be considered. Next, there is another unknown peak of 1.2, that also you can neglect. Then, the F probably has eluted with labile and carbamylated with 25.8%. P3 is normal, 3.2. A2 is 65. Then there is again an unknown peak in the retention time of 3.76 with 2.5. We usually get this type of peaks. If there is an unknown after A2, just consider the retention time. Sometimes with E homozygous also I have seen here very common, you get another small peak with the same 0.1 difference retention time. That is in his E homozygous also. Here, A2 is 65, that unknown is only 2.5. Sometimes in E homozygous, what I have seen, A2 and unknown, it can be splitted into two proportions, very high, above 10%. So you have to consider that area also to give the proper diagnosis. So what could be the diagnosis here?
The spillover.
If I say there is no history of blood transfusion.
No, it's just a spillover. So high A2 is actually spilled over on the window of 3.7.
No, that I understood. I am asking the whole, as a whole provisional, what is the chromatogram is suggestive of?
There is no blood transfusion.
There is no history of blood transfusion. F probably has eluted with labile, 25.8. A2 is 65.0.
It can be with... this is not a 1 year age, cannot term as a persistent fetal hemoglobin also. Because that is F. What is L1C is F.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is goes in favor of actually double heterozygous of
E-beta.
E-beta.
Yeah.
So it can be E-beta, and if later on it goes on, what is the blood Hb? So it's E-beta.
Yeah. So we usually get the most common cases here which we get are first is E-trait, second comes E-homozygous, third is E-beta thal, fourth comes beta thalassemia trait. Beta thalassemia major till date, I have seen maybe only one case. I have not seen.
Very natural, 25% is...
So this is the how the percentage, what we are getting. Most common cases, E trait, second comes E homozygous, then comes E beta thal. This is very, very common.
So in these cases, you always face trouble in case of A1C reporting, I suppose.
Yeah.
That is a major area of concern.
We get, in these cases, we will get A1C as 0. And in some cases, I wanted to ask Dr. Sachidananda also, in some cases, when we do the extended run, or even if there is no extended run, I have got cases with E homozygous or E beta thalassemia where usually it is not reported. We get a window of A0 of 0.0, but I have got around 3.1, 3.4 like this. So why does it happen?
About what? A1C?
For A1C, yes.
See, it's a very soft and tender point of bile. Don't discuss it over here. So I have
wanted to ask this question to Dr. Sachidananda.
I presented last year in Switzerland. I have a paper on that actually. This A1C is grossly affected by presence of hemoglobin E.
Yeah.
Because the glycosylation of E becomes the electronegativity similar of A0.
Yeah.
So whenever E is glycosylated, so even I think it's Bayra doesn't want to continue with that. So anyway, the thing is that the E1C, what is HbE1C, the glycosylation of E having electrophoretic migration similar of A0.
Yeah.
What happens, this fraction goes to the normal hemoglobin window and it's not traceable. So there lies the problem, the how much fraction is went down.
Yeah.
So there can be two solutions. One is going for another method.
Yeah, immunoturbidometry.
Yeah. And second thing, you may have some correction factors that how much of A1C can lead to what kind of correction. I think regarding HbC, Bayrad has already come up with. There was the same problem with HbS and C. Fortunately, those things are very common in US and other developed countries. So already they have come up with a solution of those. But I don't think they have yet come up with anything.
Okay, we'll discuss it.
So better not to discuss.
So here, this was a case of hemoglobin, heterozygous, compound heterozygous for hemoglobin E and beta thalassemia. Next case. 25 years female, no history of blood transfusion, hemoglobin is 9.2, RBC is 2.63, MCV is 104.6, MCH is 35, MCHC is 28.9, RDW is 14.5. If you see the chromatogram, F is 7.9, there is no unknown peak before F. Others, rest, everything is normal. A2 is normal. Adult is 78.1. As such, there is nothing in it. So what could be the diagnosis here? Only F is raised. 29 years female. Very good, very good. So this is a case which I got very recently in my lab. This is a hemoglobin F is 7.9, A2 is normal 2.6, MCV, MCH are okay. In HPFH, persistent fetal hemoglobin, hereditary fetal hemoglobin trait, what we get, MCV, MCH are in the normal range here, but F will range from 15% to 30%. But here in my case, it is only 6.7%. So you can... Yeah. So even then I thought it could be delta beta thalassemia. So I was trying to report this over enthusiastically that it could be a case of delta beta. Then I rang up the patient and I found that she was pregnant in second trimester. So that was the reason. But otherwise it was falling very correctly with delta beta thalassemia with 5 to 20%. MCV, MCH values were reduced, but in my case it was not reduced. So I asked, so the patient was found to be pregnant, so the F could be raised due to pregnancy. So this is a very interesting case which I found, so I thought of sharing it with you. This is another case. This I have taken from Dr. Soman. 13 years female, no history of blood transfusion, hemoglobin 12.7, RBC 5.08, MCV 73.6, MCH 25, RDW CV is 13.8. Here F is less than 0.8, rest everything is okay, A2 is 1.9, and there is an unknown peak with a retention time of 4.38. Area is 35.5. He has just discussed it. What can be the case? What is the case? Abnormal beta chain variant. He was discussing that. So here the retention time is 4.38, which is very close to HBQ, which he was mentioning in. So in HBQ India, we get a retention time of 4.3 to 4.5 minutes. But the A2 varies from 4 to 25%. Here it is 38.5%, so it cannot be HBQ. So it is an abnormal beta chain variant. Another case, 25 years female, no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 3.5, RBC is 1.32, MCV is 89.4. MCH is 26.5, RDW is 20.5. Here there is an unknown peak with a very small area that can be neglected, 0.8. F is 19.9, P3 is normal, 1.6, A2 is 26.9, S window is there with a retention time of 4.19. where the area is 43%. So what could be the diagnosis of this chromatogram? Sickle width? Yeah. So yesterday I have shown you. So F is 19.9. A2 is 26.9. HBS is 43. Both E and S are with E, which has eluted with A2, both E and S are raised. So it is a compound heterozygote for HBS and HBA. This I got in my lab. Another case, 35 years male, no history of blood transfusion. Hemoglobin is 14.2, RBC is 5.23, MCV is 84.6, MCH is 30.6, RDW is 12.9. Here if you see the chromatogram, F is less than 0.8, P3 is normal 3.4, A2 is 2.0, there is an unknown peak at 3.9, 34.4%. Now I want you all to answer, the beginners. Unknown peak after A2, retention time is 3.9. Yes? D, yes, very good. So, F is less than 8, A2 is 2.0, unknown window retention time of 3.9, that is 34.4%, so it is D, Punjab trait. This also I got recently in my lab. So, these are the few cases which I have shared. Thank you so much.
So, I just like to